I hope we'll have the opportunity to showcase in front of a national audience our wonderful governor and the next junior senator of the state of Colorado, Mark Udall.
The sitting governor, Democratic governor of the state, always speaks at the national convention in prime time. So you can expect to see, I'm sure Governor Ritter's probably already started working on his speech. And of course, we love to highlight our democratically elected officials from the state.
And in terms of showcasing, we're going to showcase this state. I mean, the reason Elbra, you know, had faith that one, this state would be in Democratic hands at the time that the convention was here. And I'm coming from the dark days of 1988, 1999, and 2000. And then again, 2002 to 2004, when it was Republicans across the board. But she, quite frankly, had faith that we could make some changes and turn things around because we reflected the values of everyday Coloradans. And that's what's occurred. So we're going to showcase not only how beautiful a state we have, but also the people of this state, including the elected officials.
There are dozens of organizations that are coming here, and if you think it's just the delegates, you're missing a lot of opportunities. When does this convention start? Probably a week or two ahead of time with the people coming ahead. And when does it end? Probably a lot afterwards. So if you, I wonder if you have any idea how many people, how many organizations are going to be here in addition to the DNC and having their annual meetings.
The only one that has its annual meeting concurrent with ours is the College Democrats of America. We do that on purpose, so we'd have the young people here. There are other allied organizations that come with their president and, you know, other groups of people, that they have symposia and forums and events that happen during the convention week. There are some that come 3 or 4 days ahead of time. I was talking to a gentleman the other day who wants to have a faith in public life event that will start 3 days before the convention. Who normally comes early are staff, media people. They generally come a week out because they're getting ready, they're getting set up, and they spend time getting around town, particularly the media people, because they're looking for their stories early. They want to get, you know, the slice of Colorado life, and that requires them to come about a week or so early so they can line up their stories before the convention actually starts.
Where are people going that don't have lodging to seek out lodging?
If you're a delegate to the convention, we will house you. We have a housing department that houses folks. We also house members of the media, members of the Democratic family, former presidents and former party chairs and so forth. In Lakewood, we have 7 hotels with whom we've contracted, and we will be housing in Lakewood members of the media, members of the Democratic family, partners and allies. There are other people who come to the convention who are outside of our process, who are not delegates. They're just coming and hoping they'll scrounge up a ticket from somewhere. So they are now calling around trying to find rooms. Some people go on Craigslist. There are some entrepreneurial homeowners who've listed their homes on Craigslist. That's not something that we manage, but people are being very entrepreneurial about that and finding spaces to stay in all kinds of creative ways.
And there will, you know, some families are opening their homes to a lot of young people that come to conventions and really can't afford, you know, hotel rooms. So, you know, I've had a number of people offer up their homes for young people who might be coming here. You know, the business piece too is just think about any convention of this size, which is gigantic. You know, from kind of leisure type things of bicycles and, you know, golf courses and things like that. I was asked to start reserving tee times for different individuals that might want to play golf around the area. And so a lot of these things for that week will get used up very quickly. The convention has been focused on the real nuts and bolts of one, you know, what's going to happen at the convention, what's the Pepsi Center going to look like. There's going to be a whole renovation to the Pepsi Center. Where are the delegates? Where, you know, where does each state have its hotel and all of that kind of thing? But then there's this whole leisure piece, you know, whether it's the parties or potentially it could be cultural events or outdoors types of events, you know, from kayaking on the South Platte to riding the bikes on all of our great bike trails, those kinds of things need to be considered, you know, from business opportunities.
What's a superdelegate? why is there a superdelegates? Why are there superdelegates? And would it be possible for the primaries and the caucuses to pick one candidate and the superdelegates to pick another?
The technical term is unpledged delegates. Part of the rationale for instituting that was because what was happening is that most of the delegates were elected officials, and which would not allow regular Americans to run for delegate seats and win, because they would be running against a sitting governor or running against a congressperson. So by making the elected officials automatic delegates, it gave more opportunity for grassroots people, for local, for your neighbors to run and to win delegate seats. There are actually 795 automatic delegates. Of those, 447 are DNC members. These are people who work round the clock, day in, day out, year in, year out, using their own time, their own cars, their own money, to elect Democrats up and down the ballot when people aren't watching, when it's just, when it's an off year and nobody cares who's running for president. So these are people, 447 of the 795 are DNC members. The rest are Democratic elected officials, governors, members of Congress, and so forth. So the vast majority are your neighbors, are people who have spent their lives working for the Democratic Party unpaid, because this is what they care about, and we think it's fair to give these people who've given so much of their time and their talent, to give them a vote when it comes to the national convention.